Shalom and welcome to 2 Minutes of Torah. This year is entitled "Daf Yom Ktuva Yud Amud Aleph." The Gemara is discussing the halachot of Ktuva and the man's daraita, the rabbanan obligation towards his wife. The pasuk in Mishpatim in the beginning, pasuk tet, pasuk yud, shirakshta vonata, like rather, man's obligated in several things, daraita, different shittot, exactly what the obligations are, the daraita and drabanan. Shulchan Aruch writes the following. In Samech Ted Simon, Samech Ted and Evan HaEzer, he writes that when a man writes, when he man marries a woman, Shnosi Adam Isha, Chayev Baba Asara Devarim, he's Chayev in 10 separate obligations. The Zoche Babidal Devarim, Afilin on the Chvil, and he is Zoche and 4 things from his wife. And the Shulchan Aruch goes on to list, we'll mention several of them. Yudvar mezonoteha, food, he has to sustain her. Ksuta, clothing, onata, marital intimacy. Veika ktuvata, the money of the ktuva. Refuata, to heal her. Lifdota, to redeem her. If she's a hashram taken captive. Kvurata, to go ahead and bury her when she passes away. And the Mefarshim on the side of the Shulchan Aruch discuss what are these obligations. Are they midaraita? Are they midrabanan? So the Beit Shmuel, for example, quotes the Rambam, who writes that there are 3 from the Torah. And what are they? Mizonoteha, ksuta v'onata. It's feeding her, giving her food and clothing. And intimacy, those 3 are midaraita. Others hold that the onah is midaraita, and the other 2 are midrabanan. And they discuss all the different halachot and the sources. What's midaraita? What is midrabanan? There are shittot that say the Rosh maintains that mizono is midrabanan, and onah and ksut is midaraita. That the clothing and the intimacy is midaraita. So the different variations on what the obligations are, midaraita, midrabanan, usually there's not a big nafgamina, halacha is halacha from the Torah, from the Rabbanan. But it is important to stress that there are plenty of obligations that a man is obligated towards his wife in terms of sustaining her and taking care of her physically and emotionally. And in some circles, it may be that the man is the expectation is that the man is going to go ahead and be learning for a few years, and the wife is going to be supporting him. How does one deal with these halachot? So the assumption is that the man and the wife are going in with the assumption that she is mevater, that she goes ahead and no, I'd like to if you to go ahead and learn, and I'll take care of the sustenance for a while in the family. It can have that arrangement where one is mevater, gives up on what is magia, what's coming to her. But it should be, it's important to understand the framework. The framework is midaraita. He has many, many, many obligations towards her in many ways, psychologically and financially. And if it's a case where she is being mevater, she's giving up on them, it should be an understanding. And he should understand what ideally the situation is, and what is a mevater, what is a bit of a change in the situation, just so they have a proper perspective on the Torah obligation, the Torah framework for marriage, the rabbinic framework for marriage, and then a change that is made for one reason or another, maybe legitimate reasons, maybe proper, but it's important to have the basic framework of how the Torah set up the monetary and other obligations, obligatory parts of the marriage. Shalom.